Hello friends. Okay, so today we are going to see the yield line theory of part 3. So previously we have seen part 1 and part 2. So in that part 1 we have seen the theory. In part 2 we have seen the derivations for the different shapes of slabs for yield line. And in part 3 we will see the examples today. Okay, so basically this is used for design of slabs. So we will see an example of slab design. Okay. So first of all, we'll see the problem statement. So problem statement is the design of simply supporting square slab of side 3.6 meter to carry a service load of 4 kN per meter square using M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. Okay, so in the problem they have given a simply supported square slab having a size of 3.6 meter square and service load is, that is live load is 4 kN per meter square. In 20 grade concrete we have to use and 415 Fe415 steel we have to use. So we'll see the solution there. So this is a figure of square slab simply supported all over the four sides and size of 3.6 meter by 3.6 meter. So this is the problem statement. So first of all, we need to find out the thickness of the slab. So using this equation, so span divided by overall depth is equals to 35 into 0.8 is equals to 28. Okay, so this is according to IS code 456-2000 clause number 24.1. So for simply supported slab, the ratio, the number is 35 and we have to multiply that 35 number by 0.8 because we are using HYSD steel, high yield reinforcement bars, Fe415 steel we are using, that's why we have to multiply that number by 0.8. So we will get 28. Okay, using this number, overall depth recommended is equals to 3.6 meter is the span into 1000 divided by 28, which is equals to 128.5 mm will get the thickness. So this is the overall thickness, that is capital D, we have got 128.5. is according to IS 456-2000 clause number 24.1. So let us assume the thickness capital D is equals to 130 mm. So assuming 25 mm cover, small d is equals to 105 mm. So these are the dimensions for the thickness for the square simply supported slab for the given problem statement. So according to, by using this 24.1 clause, we have to find out the thickness of the slab, thickness of the slab. So next, load calculations. Okay, so as we have found out the thickness of the slab, we can find out the self weight of the slab. So overall depth is equals to 130 mm, that is 0.130 meter into 1 meter by 1 meter we have to find out. Into density of concrete is equals to 25, which is equals to 3.25 kN per meter square. So this is the self weight of the slab. So service load they have given, service load is equals to 4 kN per meter square they have given, and floor finish is equals to, they have given 1 kN per meter square. Actually this is not given, sorry, this is not given, we are assuming that 1 kN floor finish is there, 1 kN per meter square is the floor finish is there, we are assuming this. So therefore the total load is equals to 8.25 kN per meter square. So this is the working load, this is the working load. So we have to take the factored load. So factored load is equals to 1.5 times the working load. So 1.5 into 8.25 is equals to 12.375 kN per meter square. This is the factored load. So for this load we have to design the slab. For this load we have to design the slab. Okay, so now calculation of movement. Calculation of movement. So movement from yield line. Movement from yield line. So as we have seen in the part 2 video, for square simply supported slab, so movement can be calculated by using mu is equals to wu l square divided by 24. Okay, so this is the equation or this is the formula to calculate the movement for the case of square simply supported slab. Square simply supported slab. So which is equals to, so wu is the load, factored load, that is 12.371 sorry it is 375 into 3.6 square is the length of the slab divided by 24, which is equals to, we'll get the movement is equals to 6.683 kilonewton meter. 6.683 kilonewton meter. So we have to check whether the depth is okay or not, whether the provided depth is safe or not. So limiting movement. So we know for M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel, we are using 0.138 FCKBD square. So FCK grade of concrete is 20, and B we are assuming for 1 meter length, and depth is, so small d, effective depth is 105 square. So using this movement, limiting movement is equals to 30.429 into 10 raised to 6. Okay, so that is in Newton mm, but in kilonewton meter it is 30.429, which is greater than the movement what we have calculated, that is 6.683 kilonewton meter. So hence this depth selected is satisfactory. Okay, so by using this we can check the depth, we can check, and hence the depth is, the depth provided is safe for the load. So next we'll see the equation to find out the movement capacity across the yield line is given by. So that equation is, so by using this equation we can find out the AST required. AST required. So mu is equals to, so we know what is mu here. Mu we know, which is equals to 0.87 Fy AST D into bracket 1 minus AST upon BD into Fy upon FCK. So this is the equation we can use for calculating the AST. And vice versa also we can do that. If we know the AST, area of steel, as well as vice, inversely we can find out the movement also. Okay, we can find out the movement also. So here we know the movement, here we know the movement, we have to find out, we know the depth of the slab, we know what is grade of steel, what is grade of concrete, what is the breadth, that is we are designing for 1 per meter length, and depth of the slab we know. So all the factors we know. So what is the unknown here? AST is the unknown. So we can find out the area of steel required by using this equation. So using this equation we can find out the area of steel required. Okay. Now we'll find out the AST. So reinforcement we'll find out. Okay, so from here this you can find out, so we know what is the movement, that is 6.683 into 10 raised to 6 is the movement. So what we have did is, so but which are the known values we have put into this equation. So by solving this equation we have got the area of steel is equals to 182.9 mm square. So this is the value we have got. So this is the area of steel required for 3.6 meter by 3.6 meter slab. So this is per meter length. This is the area required for per meter length, because we have taken B is equals to 1000 mm. So minimum AST also we have to calculate, because sometimes what happens is, so AST required is less than the minimum AST. So in that case we have to provide the minimum AST required. So minimum AST is 0.12%, that is divided by 100, that is 0.12% we have to provide, which is equals to 156 mm square. So here the AST required is greater than the minimum AST, we have to provide this AST. Okay, so this is also we have to check every time. Okay, so AST to be provided is equals to 182.9 mm square using 8 mm bars. So we'll assume 8 mm bars here. So assuming 8 mm bars, we can find out the spacing required. So hence S is the spacing. So pi by 4 into 8 square is the area of 8 mm bar, area of 8 mm bar divided by 182.90 is the total AST required, or AST to be provided into 1000, which is equals to 274.8 mm, which is equals to 274.8 mm. So hence the spacing required is 274, that is we can say 275. So we will provide the 8 mm bars about 270 mm center to center in both the directions, 270 mm center to center in the both the directions. So this is very simple. So we have calculated the, first of all we have calculated the depth required, second we have calculated the load calculations, third we have calculated the movement. After calculation of movement we have find out the area of steel, And after calculating area of steel, we have provided the steel required for the resistance of load to the slab. So similarly, problems may be asked for different shapes, and we know what are the equations to find out the movements or load, okay, for different shapes, which we have seen in the previous slide. So part two, in part two we have seen. So I have given all the cases, which cases can be asked for the examination, and I have given the equations by which equations we can find out the movement or load, So by using that equation only you have to provide the reinforcement. Okay. So this is the thing we have to do in this unit or in this module. So this is very simple unit. This is very easy if you'll understand. So please do your work, practice it in your home, and in next slide. So references I have given. So by using RCC design reinforced concrete structure by Dr. B.C. Punmiya, Ashok Kumar Jain and Arun Kumar Jain. And I have also used an advanced concrete design by S.S. Bhavikatti. So by using this two textbook, I have prepared this PPT. Thank you. Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you.